Hey, today guys, we're going to be building a paramotor throttle. Let's get to it. Okay, we're going to need a bicycle brake lever, shifter cable. This one is 66 inches long, shifting sheathing, a bicycle grip. Thin is good. We're going to need a momentary kill switch, wire for the kill switch. We'll need a strap for our hands, 12 to 14 inches should be good. A piece of handlebar, around 5 3/8 inches. Cable stop, assorted adhesive lined heat shrink tubing, and to tidy things up, a little bit of this stuff. We'll need some tools for the job. End cutters. If you decide to shorten your cable, cable cutters, wire strippers, some electrical tape, and a heat gun. Gonna put our cable in the handle through the little slot here and tighten her up. We'll link the cable sheathing about 4 inches shorter than the cable. I'm going to grab the adhesive line heat shrink tubing. We double it up to make it more rigid. We'll slide another piece on here that we'll use later with our kill switch wires. Now we're going to add our throttle end adjuster and a couple different sizes of heat shrink. And there you have it. Now let's work on the kill switch. Now our kill switch is meant to accommodate 16 gauge wire. So that's what we have here. So we're gonna get enough wire to be just about as long as our throttle. Get our wire strippers, about 3/8 of an inch. Another piece of heat shrink. Now we come to our handlebar. Whenever you cut it, be sure to ease the edges. And now for our strap. I had already cut the hole in the end to match the end of the tubing. Now to that last piece of heat shrink. Assorted sheathing line. Hey guys. Today we're going to be building a paramotor throttle.